Good morning. I'm Charles Osgood, and this is Sunday Morning. Have you ever had two terrific things happen to you at once? What a coincidence. You're on a roll. Or the opposite. When you're hot, you're hot. When you're not, you're not. Question is, are such coincidences proof of some mysterious force at work, or are they simply the luck of the draw? Susan Spencer will go in search of answers in our Sunday Morning cover story.
What do Thomas Jefferson and John Adams have in common?
These two guys, both presidents of the United States, both died on the same day, July 4th. Not just any July 4th, but the exact 50th anniversary of the signing of the Declaration of Independence.
A freaky coincidence, but does it have a larger meaning? Ahead on Sunday Morning.
Coincidence, or so we might say, when we run into an old friend we haven't seen for years on a street corner. But is it just a chance encounter, or is it evidence of something more? Our cover story is reported now by Susan Spencer of 48 Hours.
Bye, have a good day. Bye.
Bill and Hillary Solomon attribute their happy 16-year marriage to an unseen force, perhaps greater than love.
Too many coincidences for it to be random.
That's right, coincidence. The Solomons say a series of unbelievable coincidences really left them little choice.
Do you think you would have gotten married had this not been all such a coincidence?
I don't know that we would have met. I don't know that we would have met.
Coincidence one, Bill's mother and Hillary's father were high school friends who hadn't been in touch for 40 years when they reconnected by chance.
They realized that one had a son named Bill and one had a daughter named Hillary. The Clintons were in the White House at the time, so they thought, oh my gosh, how funny. Where does Bill live? Lives in New York, so does my daughter Hillary. We gotta fix him up.
Coincidence two. In a city of more than 7 million people, Bill and Hillary lived in the same neighborhood, on the same street, in the same building. In fact, in the very same line of apartments. There they were, just 7 floors apart.
And your parents can't believe this.
They were shocked.
Bill's mother insisted he had to call Hillary, but he played it cool. Until, coincidence three, he ran into a former coworker in his building.
I said to her, what are you doing in my lobby? She said, I have a really good friend that lives in your building. And I said, who is that? And she said, Hillary Kimmelman. Oh my God, I have her number in my pocket.
With that, Bill made the call, and the rest is history.
Coincidence is a striking co-occurrence of events that appear to be meaningfully related, but in fact are related only by chance.
Professor Jay Kohler at the Northwestern School of Law in Chicago is an expert on probability.
A classic example of coincidence would be you get to thinking about somebody who you haven't thought about for years, and you reach for the phone, and you know where I'm going with this. The phone rings. It's them. It's them.
Coincidences seem to fascinate us all, especially when they involve unlikely characters like Thomas Jefferson here. When Jefferson and John Adams signed the Declaration of Independence, they had no idea that they would one day be linked by a very freaky coincidence.
These two guys, both presidents of the United States, both died on the same day, July 4th. Not just any July 4th, but the exact 50th anniversary of the signing of the Declaration of Independence. And that was the beginning of my questioning whether there was something more to coincidence than just coincidence.
For Squire Rushnell, it was a sign. The one-time TV executive has started a successful cottage industry, books, speeches, all about coincidences, or as he calls them, GODWINKS.
A GODWINK is one of those little coincidences that makes you say two things. Wow, what are the odds of that? And I wonder, is that coincidence evidence of divine origin?
Rushnell's answer, a resounding yes.
I believe that everybody has GODWINKS. They are like gifts left on the doorstep. And my job is to get you to open the door and open your gift.
Inside that Godwink gift box, Rushnell says you might find the right relationship, like Bill and Hillary Solomon did, or even the right career.
This is the CBS Evening News. Susan Spencer reporting.
Now, there was something that caused you to be at CBS. Maybe it was a call out of the blue. Maybe it was somebody you bumped into. But maybe it wasn't by chance at all. Maybe it was by Godwink.
Maybe it was because I applied for a year.
Yeah.
So there's some research to suggest that a feeling of destiny can be good for you mentally.
But even if it is reassuring, it is not reality, according to science writer Matt Hudson, who says that while coincidences are not destiny, they are destined to happen, thanks to something called the law of truly large numbers.
It's a term that a couple of mathematicians came up with to describe this idea that with a large enough sample of events, any outrageous thing is likely to happen. Another way of thinking about it is, if you flip a coin long enough, eventually you'll get 10 heads in a row, and the universe flips a lot of coins.
All those coin flips add up to a simple mathematical answer for even the weirdest coincidences, like this one.
William Regan says he played the numbers on a fluke.
The New York State Lottery on the first anniversary of 9/11. You know what the winning numbers were?
I assume it was...
Take a guess.
I assume it was 911.
Right.
Yeah. In a world where there are lots of people and lots of events happening to lots of people every day, you're going to come across a co-occurrence of events that seems to be extremely unlikely.
You're taking all the fun out of it.
Well.
So when two former presidents died on the same day, it wasn't mystical, just mathematical. Though we tend to make these things mystical by ignoring annoying little details.
So when people were comparing Jefferson and Adams, there were lots of things they looked for that they didn't find. Were their wives born on the same day? No, scratch that. Did they have the same number of kids? No, scratch that. Did they name their kids the same thing? No. And the selection fallacy is to select out the interesting parts.
You know, it's just like we're hardwired to be amazed by these things.
Exactly. That's the power of human irrationality.
But what about the power of Godwinks or the force of destiny? Science writer Matt Hudson.
I can't rule it out, just as I can't rule out unicorns, but there's no strong evidence for unicorns.
Wow, you really are a killjoy, aren't you?
It's my job. I'm a science writer.
Mathematicians will always have an answer for everything because they have to. And I put more faith in a grand designer than I do in accidents happening numerically.
For Rushnell, the stories are evidence enough, like this one about actress Diane Lane, whose father drove a New York City taxi when she was a kid.
And he would come and pick her up after school. And she would stand on her tippy toes looking for that one cab out of all those cabs, 6F99.
Remember that number, 6F99. Shortly after her father died, Lane was in a car in Manhattan thinking about her dad.
At that moment, her car pulled to the curb, she stepped out, and her heart leapt. Pulling in right in front was cab number 6F99. Now, what are the odds that that one cab, her father's exact medallion, would be at that exact spot at that exact moment in time to give her a message of hope and reassurance?
It's all familiar territory to the Solomons, whose list of coincidences seems almost endless.
And our fathers have the same exact birthday, June 10th. And her father went to Boston University, and so did I. And his roommate from college became my dad's roommate.
Get out.
New thesis.
One thing believers and doubters agree on, you are more likely to find life's amazing coincidences if you're looking for them.
Do you think I'll have one of these today?
I bet you do. Only if you allow them.
Oh, I'm ready.
Once you see a Godwink, you see them all the time.